Hey everybody, BC, what's going on? It's Friday. I'm turning the radio off. They're talking about the Middle East. It's my habit of listening to morning NPR talks. And I just need to listen to the world to see what the tone, according to the media, is. And according to the media, the world has completely lost it. The news is completely insane. And there is absolutely no justification for this mess in the Middle East. We need to get out of there. Anyway, I'm going to talk to you for a little bit. I don't have any new records to show, but I wanted to show a few records and also talk a little bit more just about a few what's on my mind. But one of the things that I want to share is that I had my last video, I had showed you where I was working on a groove for the Strange Attractors. And it's come along a little bit. I changed the drum pattern a bit, so it's better. That was a bit clunky. And I just want to let that play a little bit in the background, then I'll show some records. Try it the other night when I showed it to him. I had the drummer over last night and we slowed this down. He can play this. It's been a week where I've been working more, and it happens like that, you know, that I'll take some time off and then I'll start to work and then that'll be what I'm doing for a while. But a few records sitting out to show you that I played was, I didn't look this up to give you information on this, Uzeb, Between the Lines. These appear to be either French or Canadian musicians. It's recorded in America in the 80s. And it's a jazz sort of thing, but also one where that fusion sort of thing is going on. This is actually, when I first bought this album, I didn't like the blend. I like what I heard yesterday. Instrumental jazz, but it has, like, again, fusion elements. Uzeb, Between the Lines. I sold most of my punk rock records, even though I still play in a punk rock band, because I like the energy, I like the guys in the band, I just like that aggression when we play. But one of my surviving punk records is BGK, Nothing Can Go Wrong, Dutch band, and it's signed by the band. I got this when we opened for them in 1986 on their American tour. RAF opened the show in Omaha, and it was a riot. One of the most fun nights I've ever had in a band was the audience. For some reason, the audience was really jacked up for the show. And the guys in BGK were just so nice. They were having a really good time. And RAF, we surprised them. You know, I brag because I can, because RAF is that good. We blew them away, you know, and they were really surprised to be playing with, you know, to find such a good band, you know, to open for them, you know, really kind of kicked them up the snout, you know, made them play harder, which was great. That's, and this is a great album. I played this. Side two is the side I really like. Youth for Crime. Excellent riff on that song. Youth for Crime. Love this. In the background, this is not punk, but this is more new music by me. As good as anybody's, it is. Eddie Jobson, Zinc, solo album. Eddie Jobson was in a bunch of different bands. Roxy Music, UK, Curved Air. On the progressive side with this, a violinist, keyboardist. Those elements come out in his writing. I love his writing. I like his sense of melody and chords. And this is a prog album that, even though there is a dated sound to the production, I really like this album, and I recommend it for folks that like progressive rock. Eddie Jobson, Zinc. I recommend this. I pulled this mainly because some people were talking about it online. It's the Day of Phoenix is the band, The Neighbor's Son. Their records are really collectible. They're very expensive, and their first album, which I don't have, is more psychedelic than this. This one you can hear where it's a rock band that's decided to try to make some money. They're good though. And who is it? Tony Reeves plays bass on here. Tony Reeves, I think the guy that was in Greenslade and possibly Coliseum. But this is a good album, The Neighbor's Son. I'm gonna take a moment here and cue up a little more music from yours truly, because here's another thing I just started last night where I'm doing something with sounds, getting a beat going. So I'll be getting back to that, but let me put some, I think what I'll do is I'll put on Flyover. I was going to put on Murphy, but I'm going to put on Flyover. I'm very proud of these albums, and I'm thinking probably a lot of you folks really haven't even heard the music, you know. So in the background, we'll listen to me. You know, we lost Edgar Froese recently, of Tangerine Dream. So he keeps popping up in conversations online. So I pulled this, Atem. And the reason why I pulled it was because another VC member was showing his copy where he had an original ore, one quadraphonic. And I was thinking, wow, that's pretty cool. I probably don't have one, but turns out I do. Mine's an original pressing on ore, or it's a quad pressing. I don't know if you'll watch this one, Andy, but I know Andy King is someone who I've met through the BC who is an expert on Tangerine Dream. And so he'll know. But this is a really dreamy, weird, intense album. Freaking fantastic. Atem, Tangerine Dream. See, check this out, people. Come on now. This is good music. That's a to like here. Or even if you don't like it, it's like, this is good work. That's good work. I do good work on my music. Another of my all-time top albums, Labyrinth by Kit Watkins. I could return to this a lot. He was the keyboardist in Happy the Man and Camel. This is just a wonderful, instrumental, flavorful, melodic, beautiful album. One of my top albums. Labyrinth. Another album that comes out of the prog but goes into jazz, Nova Vimana. Sometimes I wish I had a Vimana, fly the hell out of this place. But these guys used to be Osana, the Italian prog band Osana. And then they moved into a more fusion sound on this album, kind of like Brand X or Return to Forever. Phil Collins plays drums on some of this, as well as Narada Michael Walden. Narada Michael Walden is the main drummer on here. Yeah, Phil Collins plays percussion. And Robin Lumley from Brand X is on here. This is a pretty decent album. I had a friend over the other night. My car is down again. I think it's either the starter or the solenoid. We're supposed to try to get it running today. But anyway, we were talking about music, and I had shared with him how I had pulled a couple of records and they're going into the trade pile because, again, that's how it works. You know, most everything stays, but every now and then I find things. And this was one that I pulled thinking, you know, this could probably go, but I don't want to sell this. We played it. Fats Comet. Rockchester. Now, one of the reasons why this remains in my collection, and it still is going to for now, is it's part of the Adrian Sherwood Unused Sound production. I just love Adrian Sherwood. And again, even though there's a certain amount of datedness that you hear in his production, there's a lot of things that he did first. And Fats Comet, he uses the that team of musicians that he's known for. Keith LeBlanc, Doug Wimbish, who I met, great bass player. So this one, we listened to it, and yeah, it sounds dated, but this one stays. Listen to a local band came up. We were talking about production. My friend fancies himself to be a music aficionado. He is, to a degree. We were talking about production values, and Saddle Creek Records came up. So I put on this album by WWWZ. And they're on Saddle Creek, band based out of Omaha, Lincoln. The drummer on this album is the same drummer who is now in Sun Ambulance with me, Dave Ozinga. And we listened to this, and you know, I like this, but you know, they recorded this in the studio, but I like the production quality levels that I'm getting here at home, and we compared them. Now, the best that I could figure is that this must be the sound that they want because they're in a studio. Now, some of the songs sound a little bit like Captain Beefheart, so maybe the lo-fi aspect is on purpose, but it was kind of noticeable that this is a good album, but it's like, those production values. Maybe if any of the guys from the band see this, next time I run into y'all, you can explain to me. Because it's like, man, you could have recorded this in my living room. Good songs. The October Country. This is a compilation of four artists put out by Nate Starkman and Sons. Vaguely, somehow related to the band Savage Republic. And mid-80s. This comes from the indie rock scene where things were still kind of like all over the place. But there's a bit of a goth shoegaze feel to most of this music. This is really cool. The October Country. Marnie is the standout for me. Marnie's track is the standout. Cosmic Sound, this is a sampler, it's a compilation of French music. How do they describe this? A Voyage Across French Cosmic and Electronic Avant-Garde 1970-1980. They got it right. The selection on here is excellent. Everyone from Patrick Juvet, Space, Droids, to Jean-Michel Jarre, Cerrone, Jean-Jacques Perry, and Serge Gainsbourg. This is excellent. Double album. It's fantastic. David Vorhaus, White Noise. I have the first one on CD. Used to have the album. So dumb that I sold so many really valuable records. But I have White Noise 2, which is not quite comparable to the first album. It's interesting, you know, that he's carrying on his experiments. This is called Concerto for Synthesizer. I'm glad I have it. One of the original early drummers for Dead Can Dance, Peter Ulrich. This is a solo single of his, Takaharu's Leaving. Sounds like Dead Can Dance in a lot of ways. Has that moody, kind of almost gothic, processional sort of feeling. There's even a song on here called Evocation. And it's what it is. It sounds like something formal, heavy. Another conversation online brought me to pull this album. I hadn't played in a while, and this is amazing guitar work. Amazing. Hans Reichel, The Death of the Rare Bird Ymir. Hans Reichel is gone, but he was also a guitar inventor. Came up with an instrument called the daxophone. People that know Fred Frith's work might know Hans Reichel. This is some amazing work. It's like, wow, I was really kind of floored at how good it's imaginative, it's unique, but you can hear how brilliant of a guitarist the man is. You know, it's like, because he'll go to places where it's really familiar and then he just flies off way out. And his technique is amazing. Hans Reichel. Free music production album. Again, Brett Helm comes to mind from the BC because his band Audra played a show with Ultra Bidet. He shared that with me. And this is one that I had pulled thinking I might be ready to put this up for trade. Ultra Bidet. Super Milk. No, man, this is good. I think this band is out of Japan. They got signed to Alternative Tentacles. So there's kind of it's not punk, but there's a rough edge to it, but it's also noisy and kind of experimental. It's on white vinyl too. So this is a keeper. And I shout out to Brett Helm again because, again, he shared with me that he had a good gig with these guys. Ultra Bidet. Good stuff. Preview 73 with the Books. Preview 73 reads the Books. I have one album by the Books that was given to me by Tim Guthrie. It still hasn't made an impression. This has. Preview 73 with the Books. This works. This is pretty cool. A lot of sampling going on here. I will make this criticism. I can make better beats than what's on here. I know that's not necessary, but that's what. If I want to do it, I'll do it. You know. What's the harm? The harm is that out of millions of people on this planet, maybe one person won't like it and will be offended. So the fuck what, you know? I'm not doing it on purpose to anyone. I'm just being me. Just being me. Yellow Magic Orchestra. Service. My dogs. This album has Snake Man Show on it, so there's this in Japanese dialogue comedy sketch going on in between the songs. I don't know what's going on, but the songs are amazing. Yellow Magic Orchestra, Service, YMO. Bola Sete, guitarist. I forget where he's from. Is he from Haiti? Gorgeous. So solo acoustic guitar, it sounds like the cover. It's like, who else plays like this? I can't think of another guitar player who sounds like this. It's beautiful. Acoustic guitar, beautiful. Bola Sete. Sounds like the cover. It does. It's beautiful. Robbie Robertson from the band. Honestly, the reason why I keep this, it's a good album, but the main reason why I bought it was because Peter Gabriel sings guest vocals on this. The whole album is good, but generally where this music is coming from does not reflect the space that I'm living in or trying to be in my head. I love Peter Gabriel's voice, and so I love it when he comes in on the song Fallen Angel. To me, this is an album that deserves better. Jam Factory. Look at that cover. It's one of those funk soul bands from the 70s who kind of come from a Sly and the Family Stone sort of trip. Unfortunately, this album, this band tries too many things and they fail at most of them. And so the album is inconsistent, but there's a couple of really good songs in here. The first track is good. Tight Knit Group, You Better Listen is really good on here. But there's some clunkers on here too. But if you see this, it's worth it for the cover, but really, there's some good jammers on here. Also, Joe English was in the band. I think that's him right there. He went on to play drums for Paul McCartney and Wings for years. Last thing I'll show is Jan Garbrek Quartet, Afrik Pepperbird. Jan Garbrek is kind of like one of the staple artists on ECM, or was for years. It's kind of like Keith Jarrett. But this is one of his best albums, with Terry Ripdahl. Really fiery, really excellent. And this music in the background, I just love this. That ending is completely YMO. Okay, folks, my car's down. I did get a couple of record orders, and I will try to get those in the mail today because I haven't been able to go anywhere. I have a friend who's supposed to come over and help me today. It's either my starter, the solenoid, or something, but I'm homebound, and hopefully we'll get the car running today, and I'll get the latest record sales out in the mail today. I'd like to shout out to everybody by name, but I can't remember you all. This community, the sense of community in my mind, you know, is important to me, and I just am glad that it exists. Groove. Are you kidding me? Come on. I often wonder if some of the BC members didn't know this was me and heard it. Guarantee you, their response would be way different. Because this music is badass. Saying much love.